That's kind of funny, right? He's both in universe, like aged up artificially, but also they've got that's some good old age makeup on. And how old is he? Bernard Hill, right?
Hill.
That's his name. Yeah.
Will you do nothing?
When he was filming this, he would have been what, 60? Late
60s,
mid 60s, I think.
Yeah, 60. Because he's in his 80s now.
Damn, he's great in this. Well, I mean, he's because he's in Titanic as well, right? That's the main thing I remember from other than this.
Well, he was the captain, right?
Yeah.
Be careful what you say. Do not look for welcome here.
He had his own private death scene while everything else was going on.
The iceberg calls for aid. Titanic shall answer.
Yeah, I do like that. It's like, okay, we're back. Where were we?
Someone's in for an ass whooping.
Well, the thing is, you can't help but imagine like all of what just happened is this guy's fault to a significant extent. So. What does everyone think about Aragorn forcing him to spare him?
I mean, just, you know, mercy, and he's defenseless here.
No, my lord! No, my lord!
I mean, he does have valuable intel about Rohan that he probably shouldn't allow to fall into enemy hands.
That
but,
is the criticism, but...
Yeah.
Let him go. Enough blood has been spilled on his account.
I mean, maybe just put him in prison or something until all this is over, rather than kill him.
Okay, Theoden, now you can kill him.
Get out of
my way! Yeah, I think one would argue is just a lot of things are happening all at once, and I don't know, maybe they didn't think through how bad it would be to let him go.
At the same time, it's like, man, you know, like, he knows a lot.
Hail Theoden King!
Is it Wormtongue that talks about the weakness of Helm's Deep?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Where is my son?
Man, it's only just got him into this film, but he has like a big old weight on him for acting to do.
Pulls it off.
This actor, you know, did this. He did Titanic before it. He did this, and then not really any other huge roles for him.
He was in Valkyrie.
Valkyrie?
Only the beginning,
like
though.
Yeah, like 2 minutes.
But that's the thing. I struggle to remember what else he was in at all.
Maybe after he did this, he was like, you know what? I'm good. I'm done.
My career is peaked.
Symbolmuna.
Because a lot of the actors from Lord of the Rings went on to all kinds of things, you know? But a lot of them were doing this after having done all kinds of things.
Open war is upon you, whether you would risk it or not.
The fact that Theoden just instantly, you know, jumps into action after having been, like,
He's been through a hell of a lot.
He's had a lot to grapple with in a very short amount of time, but, like, he embraces it.
When last I looked, Theoden, not Aragorn, was king of Rohan.
Jeez.
This is not a defeat. We will return. We will return.
Yeah, if it was more like for himself, well, obviously more for himself than anybody else.
Watch where you're swinging that thing.
Those without swords can still die upon them. I fear neither death nor pain.
No, do you?
I fear both of those things considerably. In fact, those are my two biggest weaknesses, is death and pain.
What do you fear, my lady?
A cage. To stay behind bars until use and old age accept them.
You're a daughter of kings. A shield maiden of Rohan.
She really likes this guy.
Yeah.
He's pretty awesome, pretty great. I like his red shirt.
So few of you have returned.
Yeah, shit sucked.
Our people are safe.
But now...
That's what he's thinking about. Yep, our people are safe.
Yep. He's just a Chad. Like, he really
all the
is.
Way through, all the way through.
Especially considering that he's just gotten done with being like a floompy old man to
right? and
like rallying all of his people.
And his son died. Yep. And his nephew is now banished and he can't get him back.
And it's just like he's now in this massive pressing problem that he has to solve.
Mm-hmm.
Which is that there were sure
he has so much self-doubt, but he comes through like every time.
Yeah. Yep.
All Isengard is emptied.
How many?
10,000 strong at least to destroy the world of men.
He's had so many problems to deal with.
Yeah, and
it's such a short amount of time.
He's still going to take a head on because he's like, you know what, fuck it. Helm's Deep's pretty good, so, like, we can do this, even if it is 10,000, right?
Not much option either. It's not like they can run.
Well, they could all go out through the back or whatever, but I don't know. It's just how long is that even going to buy you?
It just keeps delaying it, exactly. Yeah. Like, this is their best opportunity. Helm's Deep is, like, a good place to mount a defense.
Come to destroy his people.
down to the last child.
Aragorn, stop announcing that shit. This is a seriously good point from Rohan. Sorry, he is Rohan, to be honest with you. But
from Rohan.
Theoden, like, it's almost a flaw to be like, why the fuck would you just like be talking about this so publicly, how much we're going to lose? You
must. Well, it's all about morale.
Well, and what's really cool about it is that Legolas does it later and Aragorn calls him out for it.
Yep.
Right.
There's a lot for Aragorn to learn from Theoden, even though you would be older than him, right?
We are not so lucky in our friends as you. The old alliances are dead.
Gondor will answer.
Gondor. No, my lord, Aragorn.
How awesome is it, this performance, and the fact that it's showing Theoden is fucking worried?
Yes.
He's putting on an act for his men.
Like my men, the courage hangs by a thread.
As he says, like, their courage hangs by a thread, and it's up to us to present an image of strength.
I wonder if he thinks that of himself, too, that he's worried he'll fail.
We are alone.
We are alone.
You won't be, sir, and it'll be invigorating. And it would be so easy not to help them back.
Mm-hmm. And yet...
And yet.
Because they
gotta deal with all of our own problems.
Absolute Chad.
That's what I mean. He's handling all of this so well, but he's seen as, like, it's that speech that Saruman gives about him, the dressing down of him, that's so, like, unfair and cruel. And that's another thing that got fucking cut, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
We are alone.
You won't be, sir, and it'll be invigorating. And it would be so easy not to help them back.
Mm-hmm. And yet.
And yet.
Because
they gotta deal with all of our own problems.
Absolute Chad.
That's what I mean. He's handling all of this so well, but he's seen as, like, it's that speech that Saruman gives about him, the dressing down of him, that's so, like, unfair and cruel. And that's another thing that got fucking cut, by the way.
God, so many orcs.
Ah, yeah.
Yes.
Damn.
Fuck him up.
And he's still.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Get him, Theoden.
Get him, motherfucker.
How long do you need? As long as you can give me.
Yeah, pretty much as long as whatever you can get.
Like, yeah, a couple of weeks would be fine. You would think if they knew, like, they were going to be under siege, it's like, you know what? We'll just pile rocks behind that gate. Like, nothing's getting through that ever. He's pretty down in the dumps here.
A little bit.
Yep.
Aragorn ain't down yet.
Starting the black pill.
No.
The fortress is taken. It is over.
Let's ride out and fuck them up.
Please, have any of you defeated an ice troll?
I have. Me too.
There is one passage. It leads into the mountains.
Yeah, I don't know. I've always felt like they probably should have been cycling them out of that pass to begin with.
Yes.
The big insurance policy.
Well, that's a big cave system.
What can men do against such reckless hate?
We can fight.
The horn of Helm Hammerhand shall sound in the deep one last time. Yes!
Yeah!
Yes!
Yes!
We draw swords together.
Let this be the hour when we draw swords together.
Yeah!
So fucking good.
Yep.
Fell deeds awake.
This moment.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Now for wrath. Now for ruin. And the Red Dawn.
I like this more than the charge of Rohan at the Pelennor Fields. It's so fucking hopeless here.
Yeah.
Like, they're just going for it knowing they're gonna die.
Course they are
They're both pretty great. I get fired up by both of them. Of the scene where they're going down the little causeway here, and it's just
fucking pouring them off.
Just pouring them off, yeah.
And just plowing through all of the...
Which, by the way, I can pretty much buy this part. It's when they get down to the bottom, I'm like, oh, they're in trouble.
They're in big trouble.
And Rohan will answer.
Yeah!
Muster the Rohirrim.
That's like an Avengers Assemble kind of line. Like, muster the Rohirrim.
It's what you want. Yeah, it's what everyone wants.
I love it when they muster.
Really cool. And who's going to do it now? Who's going to do it now in Avengers? The Kang Dynasty, written by Michael Waldron.
Assemble the army at Dunham. As many men as can be found.
It's said it so many times, but Theoden is so awesome.
I love Theoden.
We ride for Gondor. And war.
Oh, that armor, it looks so fucking good.
I have a replica of that helmet. It's unbelievable.
And what a relief to see these lads after a while. Right.
Well, yeah, because we know that these are the people being led by somebody who's actually, like, intelligent, courageous, and
heroic.
For the people. Yeah, acts like a really strong foil to Denethor.
Aiden, he came from a low. He was in a low. A very, very bad one as well. But he managed to overcome
it. Well, that's gotta be deliberate, right? The contract. Denethor thinks himself so far above his station, like, what he deserves, what he is. while Theoden is constantly insecure about like an imposter, essentially, like he shouldn't
be here. And that insecurity actually spurs him to become very much not an imposter. He is an incredibly noble and genuine article character.
And absolutely comes through while Denethor fails miserably.
Juxtapose the, I guess you could say, some form of complacency with Denethor there sitting gobbling down his food while his men are sent out to die for no reason. Then we immediately cut to Theoden leading the armies of Rohan.
Both men don't feel like they're good enough.
But one of them does something about it.
We have till dawn, then we must ride.
You could even compare their lines, right? I will not bow to this ranger from the north versus last time I checked, it was Theoden who was king of Rohan. Like this frustration with Aragorn and his lineage, but at the same time, Theoden does heed Aragorn's advice, work with him, fight with him, and win with him.
I would have you smile again.
Oh, he's asking her to smile.
Wow, what a misogynist.
You shall live to see these days renewed.
His facial hair is just like the perfect, like, amount of, like, gruff to it, and it's shaped, like, it's like a trimmed hedge.
No more despair.
It is a perfect mix of nature and, what is it, like,
not nature.
Huh? I love nature. Nature's great.
I know your face. Heroine.
Crazy to think about when we first saw him. He was just old and decrepit and pale, and Grima Wormtongue and Saruman were, like, controlling him.
I'm going to save.
And then at the end, he saved Minas Tirith, he saved men!
I go to my fathers, in whose mighty company I shall not now feel ashamed.
One of the best kings ever.
Theoden.
One of the most pivotal characters.
Theoden is, I love his redemption arc. After falling in, you know, under the spell and, you know, just absolutely being devastated within the movie. I'm talking about the movie concept of it. So he's being taken over by Saruman and Wormtongue has gotten to him. And when he wakes up, his son is dead and he feels like he's failed his niece and nephew completely. He fails his kingdom. This man just feels like he's not worthy of being a king. And he fights through that. He needs help. But he's such a good man. He's such a good man at the end. And it's played so well. Plus, he has the best fucking speeches. And he also works kind of as a surrogate for the audience when you're like in the middle of this battle. He's like, how in the fuck did we get here? Like, what, you know, what happened to men? You know, the days have gone down in the West. And it's such a brilliant performance through and through. That's why he's my favorite character. But I love a good redemption arc. Mm-hmm. So not that it was necessarily his fault, but still. And he takes responsibility. I like that too.